2 hours, 4 days.
Okay.
The first day will be a very general discussion about news in its different forms, mm-hmm. news as it's changed with the internet, mm-hmm. how in some ways a newspaper of kind that we grew up with has almost become irrelevant.
Yes.
And so how you write for that, how you would write for a newspaper to make it relevant, mm-hmm. and to talk about what kind of newspaper they would like to create, what focus they would like. Then we will split the group and discuss story ideas, and maybe I'll ask them to do a minimal amount of research when they go home,
mm-hmm.
so that they can come the next day, and then I will give them topics for news reports.
Right.
We will write the news reports together, I will go through them.
Right.
And then maybe do a feature for the next day, and on the last day, put everything together.
Oh yeah, basically we'll be going through a lot of theatre games and exercises all designed to make the child express themselves in whatever way they want. And I'll be creating a safe environment. No one's judged, it's not a contest. And that's one of the plus points of the workshop. I'm going to make them feel totally comfortable to be as crazy as myself. Why? Confidence is important. I'm not really focusing on drama, but confidence. Why? Because if you're confident and relaxed, you'll perform anything in life. Whether it's class presentations, whether it's marriage proposals, or whether it's drama itself. So games, monologues, theater games, like the zombie game, where you all act like a zombie.
This workshop is finding physical characters. A wonderful actor can observe those things and take it from them and steal it from them and imbibe it in your own body and bring it out for people, for performers, audience.
So our workshop is basically from scratch. No matter how much people know about theater, we tell them straight away that forget everything you know, you start from scratch.
Sure.
Basically you need to understand that you know nothing about theater, I know nothing, we're learning together.
Right.
What you learn is what I learn as well.
Mm-hmm.
We need to learn that each child has a different grasping power.
Right.
Everyone can't learn at the same pace. At the same time, it's about self-confidence, it's about speech, and it's not about becoming the best actor there is. It's about just being ready for life post this. It's not just an acting workshop. It's about being able to deal with life, because the age group we're teaching is 12 to 18.
Right, and that's a tricky age group.
It is, because they can get very much in their own shell, or they can really be out there and extroverted. So we try and bring everyone on a level playing field.
Mm-hmm.
So everyone needs to realize that, okay, the person in my group, because a lot of group activities.
Yeah.
So the person in my group is as important as me. These are the kind of things we kind of teach them over there in our workshop.
It's going to be very, very, very intensive workshop where we understand about photography right from the history to how to handle the camera properly. Like, the stability is very important. What makes an image a better image than a boring image? How do you compose? What are the technicalities, the physics and the maths that we use in photography? Yes, we will use it all.
So a lot of hands-on experience.
Yes,
is what
yes,
we're gonna
very
get.
Much. But for the technicals, if you have the manual mode in the camera, it will be much useful, because that's where we play the games with physics.
And sure.
Look for good light, okay? Shoot in good light. You don't want hazy or dull or dark picture. Try to have shadows as well in the images, and don't frame in the middle. Don't put your subject in the middle. These are the three quick tips
I
would like to give you.
That's kind of awesome. First of all, they break the ice. They come to know each other. They come out over here in the lawns, get the feel of the trees, the leaves, the insects and birds. Then we go indoors. I can tell them stories from my book, various books on nature. And ultimately, we get down to writing. We can write poems, we can write skits, we can write stories. And the final aim is to create a little booklet. Each child is going to create a little booklet on nature by the end of the workshop.
Sure. Sir, this workshop is a great learning experience. The puppets help to develop social and motor skills. They meet visual, tactile, and emotional needs of children. A puppet can encourage the quietest of child to start talking. Puppets provide an effective means to initiate communication. Along with developing language skills, puppet play helps in social and emotional development. They boost cognitive development as well as fine motor skills.
Mmm, looks like a great deal.
Okay, what's wonderful about Dipna is she works with a lot of tactile stuff. So she might use Play-Doh, she might use things that have a different texture on it. Mm-hmm. And that translates to getting them to think about, okay, how does this feel? And how do I feel? And then using music as well to make them think about, okay, I'm feeling a certain way, so can I move a certain way right. as well?
So it's and more sensorial.
It's about sensory things, also to use visual stimuli, different yeah. pictures, okay. and get them to think about what's happening in the picture,
right.
and then respond with movement.